Welcome back to our MedSmarter Question of the Week, where we're taking a smarter approach to preparing future physicians. Before we get started, if you'll click that like button, and also subscribe and turn the bell on so that you'll be notified when we post new videos. All right, let's get right to that question. This one is pretty much a short vignette, so we're going to go ahead and just read the whole thing because there's only a few words that we're missing without the last sentence. A patient is being treated with beta blockers for hypertension. Which of the following describes the effects of beta blockers on end-diastolic volume, blood pressure, contractility, heart rate, and ejection time? So this question is just asking us to know what the effects of a particular medication are. Don't get overwhelmed by seeing this chart because this is a fairly straightforward question. So we all know right from the start that beta blockers are going to slow the heart rate. So we can come through here and we can mark out any answer choice that causes an increase in heart rate. So B and E are going to be out because they do not fall in line with a decrease in heart rate. We know beta blockers are used for hypertension, so it's going to cause a decrease in our blood pressure. But all of these answer choices, as you see here, have a decrease in blood pressure, so that can't rule any further out. So if we decrease our heart rate, we're going to decrease oxygen consumption, and that will also decrease our contractility. Therefore, we can rule out anything that has an increase in contractility or little to no effect. So that is E and A. So now we're down to C and D. So if we are decreasing our heart rate, that gives us more time to fill up the heart and more time to empty the heart. So we're going to increase our ejection time. Only one of these answer choices gives us an increase in ejection time, and that is D. Therefore, D is going to be our final answer. And D is the correct answer. So our beta blockers will decrease contractility, as we see in D, and it also decreases our heart rate. Therefore, we have a decreased oxygen consumption. That will allow for an increased end-diastolic volume due to a longer diastolic filling time, increased ejection time, to get all of that end-diastolic volume out. One further thing that you didn't have to know to answer this, but that beta blockers decrease the secretion of renin, therefore our renin-angiotensin cascade is going to be diminished, and that is what reduces our blood pressure. If you found this material helpful for your studying, please like and consider subscribing to the channel. Also, share this video so that more people can benefit from it like you have.